cheese with motion. To know the concept of the wave motion, let's do an activity as shown in the white in this board. Activity 1, defining the concept of wave and its role in energy transfer. For example, the dominoes. You see these dominoes? What will happen if you push the first domino by your hand? The first domino will fall in its place and transfer the energy to the second domino. And the second domino will fall also in its place and transfer the energy to the third and so on till the last domino also will fall in its place. What we see or know from this activity? In this activity, we know that the wave is a disturbance. In this activity, we see a wave. What is the meaning of wave? Wave is a disturbance in the medium. In this activity, the medium is the dominoes block. Okay? The disturbance in the medium that propagates. Propagates means spread and transfer energy. In wave, we only transfer energy without any movement or any transfer in the medium particles. The medium particles only vibrate in its place. Again, the medium particles in the wave motion only vibrates in its place. So it don't move or transfer from one place to another. But the energy is transferred as usual, okay? The only thing which is transferring is the energy. Again, what is the meaning of wave? Wave is a disturbance in the medium that propagates and transfers energy in the direction of propagation. The direction of propagating in this activity, in this direction, to the right direction. So this is the direction of wave propagation. And so the energy transfer in the same direction of the wave propagation. The second activity, to know the concept of wave motion. Wave motion. In this example, we will get a glass tube, a candle, and a tiny fork, and incense stick. Again, in this activity, glass tube, tiny fork, and candle, and incense stick. First, we will light the incense stick and put it in front of the glass tube. And then we will hit the tiny fork and put it behind the incense stick. The tiny fork will vibrate and we will hear its sound. The tiny fork will vibrate and we will hear a sound. And sound is energy. So the sound energy will transfer through air to the candle flame and it makes the candle flame also vibrate. So the vibration transfer from the tiny fork to the candle flame without any transfer in the medium particles. The air particles here vibrate in its place, but it don't transfer from here to here. And the evidence is the incense stick still here. The vapor of the incense stick still in this area and don't pass to the other end of the glass tube because the air vibrates in its place and don't transfer from one end to another. So, what is the meaning of wave motion? Wave motion is the vibration of the medium particles, at certain moment in a specific direction. In certain moment and specific direction or a definite direction. Another concept, what is the meaning of line of wave? something from left to right. So left to right is the line of wave propagation, as it is the direction of wave's propagation. The direction of wave propagation. So the particles of medium don't move from their places, but they vibrate on, okay? We classify waves into two types. So we have two types of waves. According to what? According to number one, according to the direction of medium particles relative to the direction of propagation. Again, the first classification is according to the vibration of medium particles direction relative to the direction of wave propagation. And here we divide it into two types of wave: transverse wave and longitudinal wave. Here we will see what is the meaning of transverse wave and longitudinal wave. First, transverse waves. What is the meaning of transverse wave? We will get a spiral spring. Spiral spring. And hold one end by our head, and the other end we will fix it to the wall by a nail. Catch the one end of spring and move it up and down. Up and down. We will see a wave forming. Forming what? Forming crests. This is the highest or the maximum displacement to the upper part. And we will see troughs. We will see crests and we will see troughs. So the transverse wave is a disturbance which causes the particles of medium to vibrate. Vibrate how? Perpendicular. Perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation. Again, what is the meaning of transverse wave? Transverse wave. This is the direction of the wave propagation. And this is how the wave transfer or the medium particles vibrate. It vibrate perpendicular. It vibrate perpendicular to the direction of the wave propagation, forming crests and troughs. And this is known as transverse wave. What is the meaning of crest? Crest, it is the highest point of the particles of the medium in the transverse wave. What is the meaning of troughs? Troughs is the lowest point of the particles of the medium in a transverse wave. So it is highest point, and this is the lowest point of the particles vibration in transverse wave. The second type of wave, we said we have transverse and longitudinal. The second type is longitudinal wave. What is the meaning of longitudinal wave? Longitudinal wave, it is the disturbance which causes the medium particles to vibrate. Here, it vibrates along mean in the same direction, along to the direction of wave propagation, not perpendicular, but along mean in the same direction. So the longitudinal wave, the medium particles vibrate along to the wave propagation, and it consists of compressions and rarefactions. Compressions and rarefactions. For example, the sound wave. So this is compressions and this is rarefaction. What is the meaning Compression is the area of highest density and compression. This is the area of highest density and compression for the medium particles. Rarefaction. Rarefaction, it is the area of lowest density and pressure. Lowest density and pressure for the medium particles. So the longitudinal wave is the disturbance which causes the particles of the medium to vibrate along to the direction of wave propagation. Now we see some real life application in our life about the waves. For example, jacuzzi. Jacuzzi, it's a tube where water moves in the form of circles. In jacuzzi, water moves in the form of circles. It's used to treat sprains and cramps. Sprains and cramps. By using hot water. What will happen if we use cold water? We use cold water to treat the nervous tension. So hot water to cure the sprains and cramps, and cold water to treat the nervous tension. And this is the first classification of waves, as we see according to the vibration of the medium particles relative to the vibration of the wave propagation. The second type of classification according to the ability to propagate and transfer energy. The ability to propagate and transfer energy. We classify it into mechanical wave and electromagnetic wave. Mechanical wave and electromagnetic wave. What is the difference between mechanical wave and electromagnetic wave? Mechanical wave, like sound waves and water waves. The sound waves and the water waves need a medium. The medium, solid or liquid or gas, need a medium in order to propagate. So they propagate in different media with many velocity. The solid has a velocity, the liquid has a velocity, and the gas has a different velocity. But they can't propagate in vacuum. Vacuum means space. And it's much slower than the electromagnetic wave. The mechanical wave classify into transverse waves and longitudinal waves. So we can count a transverse mechanical wave, and also we can find longitudinal mechanical wave. And B, electromagnetic wave. Wave which don't need any medium to transfer. It can transfer in vacuum. It can transfer in space. For example, the red wave and the light wave. And it is very fast. Its velocity in space can reach 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. The light energy or the light wave can travel in space in high velocity, which is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. The electromagnetic wave, all are transverse wave. We don't have longitudinal electromagnetic wave. And its measuring unit is meter. the maximum displacement achieved by the wave? Is the maximum displacement achieved by the particles of the medium away from their rest position? And its unit is meter or centimeter. The third concept is wave velocity. What is the meaning of velocity? Velocity equals speed. What is the meaning of speed? The speed or the velocity is the distance covered by the wave in 1 second. The distance covered by the wave in 1 second. And the unit is meter for distance and second for the time. Wave velocity can differentiate between a medium to another. Each medium has its own velocity. So, it's constant through the same medium, but different from one medium to another. Frequency, number four, frequency is the number of complete waves in 1 second. It is the number of complete waves in 1 second. Frequency hertz, the unit of frequency is hertz. The periodic time is seconds and it equal 1 over frequency and here equal 1 over periodic time. The wave propagation law. We have law to know the wave propagation, which is wave velocity v equal frequency times wavelength. And this is for today. See you next time. Goodbye. Thank you.